So macOS Mojave adds a lot of new great features to our Macs, but it also removes a few features. With every OS upgrade, we get lots of new stuff, but old features sometimes get retired or sometimes features are removed for other reasons. Let's take a look at some of the things that we had in High Sierra but now are missing in Mojave. Let's start with Mail. Mail used to have this feature in it for templates. It was called Stationery. And there were all these predefined stationery things like little birthday cards and invitations and things like that. And they were really colorful and lots of graphics. They looked really good. But it's probably a good idea that they're gone. Why? Because, well, you don't know what the person at the other end is using to view their email. They could be using a web-based email viewer like Yahoo or Gmail. They could be using a mobile device, Android, iOS, maybe an older mobile device as well. And each of these viewers has different capabilities. So they may not have seen exactly what it was that you sent. It may not look very good. It may even be on a small screen and be unreadable to them in that kind of format. So it's best for communication to actually send a simpler email, not use complicated templates like this. And of course also sending an email that's maybe several hundred K in size just to convey a few lines of text isn't a good idea if somebody's over a mobile network too. So these are gone. You can still use lots of rich formatting. That hasn't changed in Mail. And you can copy and paste elements from Pages or Text Editor or something in there maybe to accomplish a similar effect. There's just no more of this stationary and template kind of functionality in Mail. Another feature that's gone is CoverFlow. CoverFlow was a way to view files in the Finder and it was really handy for viewing lots of images. You can flip between them. Now in Mojave we have a new view called Gallery View and that replaces CoverFlow. And it pretty much performs the same functionality but it definitely looks different. Instead of seeing these huge icons at the top of the screen that you can flip through, now you have these small icons at the bottom and a large preview in the middle. So some people may miss CoverFlow and have to get used to using Gallery View instead. Another feature that's gone is the integration of social media networks right into the operating system. And this is probably a good thing. Previously, we could sign into Facebook or Twitter or even Vimeo and Flickr right in System Preferences in the operating system, add it as an account. And then system-wide, you could share things directly to these accounts and they had other hooks too. For instance, you saw your Facebook friends appear in contacts. So these are gone most likely because of privacy concerns, right? A lot of people concerned about privacy with these different networks. There's been a lot of scandals and probably Apple thought it was a good idea not to have a direct tie-in with the operating system to these social media networks. You can still post to them. You can still go to their web pages, use their functionality just as you could before you had this system integration. And certainly apps can actually hook directly into them as well. You just don't have kind of macOS hooking directly into Facebook, which is probably a really good thing. Another network type thing that's gone is something called Back to My Mac. Now, this was a way for you to log into your Mac remotely. So you could be traveling and you could use your Apple ID to basically either screen share or file share with your Mac. Now, all the functionality is still there. You can still screen share. You can still file share. Back to My Mac was just a way of finding your Mac remotely. And it was handy, but very few people actually used it. So, if you're worried about screen sharing, things like that going away, they haven't at all. There's been some misinformation there. Just the Back to My Mac functionality that very few people used. There are still lots of solutions, lots of third-party solutions for finding your Mac. And, of course, a lot of people don't even need this anymore because if you're using iCloud to store your files, you have access to all your files everywhere. You don't have to use something that actually grabs the files directly off the hard drive. You can use cloud solutions for that instead. So that's probably one of the reasons why Back to My Mac was discontinued and isn't in Mojave anymore. Now one of the things not gone in Mojave is the ability to use 32-bit apps. So all Macs for the last 10 years are 64-bit processors and you should be using 64-bit apps with them. But they still support all 32-bit apps. So if you have an old app or a developer that hasn't updated their app in a long time, you can still use those apps in Mojave. But you do get a warning now. Why? Because Apple's been warning developers for years that a future operating system will only support 64-bit apps. And now they're saying, okay, Mojave is the last operating system that will support 32-bit apps. Next year we will most likely get a version of macOS that doesn't support them. So if you see a message saying that an app needs to be updated and optimized by the developer, that means that that app is old and it's 32-bit, and either you need to use the current version of the app from that developer, or perhaps if that app has now been abandoned by the developer, move on to a new app that does the same thing, and you've got about a year to do that before the next version of macOS comes out. But for now, those 32-bit apps still work fine. You just get the little warning.